How about we actually get started? Which language will I play in? How about this one? Nah. The only one I can understand. Oh, I can actually go back. Okay, cool. I didn't know that. This is the look that I picked for my character on my main file. Let's have you be our stream file character. And what will our stream character be called? I don't know if it's gonna be ridiculous or not. Vickles. And let's go on ahead and get a new hairstyle. Cornrows. Nah. No. Just no. Long and straight. Well, I kind of like that. Pixie cut? Nah. Two block. I was expecting Minecraft blocks. Bowl cut. Space buns, so Princess Leia. I thought that said asymmetrical boob. I need to get my mind out of the gutter. Asymmetrical bob. Hey, look, it's the long boob. Alright, I kinda like this one, so I think I'll go with that one. Yeah. Might also see if I can change the, text speed. Let's change the look as well. Oh, I think I skipped over this on my base file. Cool. Oh, I can only do one of those. Eh, no beauty spot. Ooh, let me see if I can get see if I can get stream colors going. That's purple. What would a deeper purple be? Burgundy. Nah, I guess that'll work. Oh, I can't see it underneath the, hair. Kind of like this one. Let's do that. Oh, that works. Oh. Nice. Yellow green. I'm a soulless being. Okay, that's actually creepier. I'll just do that. No, no, no. That works. And I didn't see. Okay, yeah, there's color. You know, I kind of like the red look. All right, that's our character. Ready. Oh, looks like I fell asleep at my desk. Such is the life of a student. When you see now saving on the screen, your progress is being automatically saved. You can disable autosave in the menu, which I probably will be doing. Because I think I remember there being, like, a little issue with autosave when Sword and Shield initially launched. Taking lessons from tradition, growing stronger and greater. It's time for you, too, to dive into the world of Pokemon. Just avoid the fans. They can never be satisfied. Truly. Director Clavel, head of Naranja Academy. Paldea is a sprawling region, bursting with lush nature and magnificent landscapes, with a mysterious cloud cover in the center of the island, for no apparent reason. It is also, of course, home to the mysterious creatures known as Pokemon. They reside here, in great numbers, in fact. Right here in this very Pokeball. Great numbers in this one Pokeball right here. I'm also reminded of that picture of Satoru Iwata holding the bunch of bananas. Pow me. The Pikachu of this region. Pokemon can be found living all over, in the seas, in the skies, even in our cities and towns. We humans coexist with Pokemon as we both help one another to live and thrive. Naranja Academy is here to help you learn even more about these precious partners. Within our halls, people from all regions gather and study together with our iPad minis that are not actually iPad because this is Pokemon. That is a regional Tauros. And as Pokemon trainers, they have their Pokemon do battle growing alongside them. I want that Tauros. While our robust curriculum of coursework helps our students draw forth their fullest potential. I seriously want that Tauros. It is within these halls that you'll find your friends, your Pokemon, and your true self. We, the faculty and staff of Naranja Academy, can't wait to welcome you with open arms. Also, they gave Magnemite a legitimate metal texture. Another day being a flying lizard. Burb. Tauros, I want one. Flamingos! I might want one of those.
A lighthouse. Oh, nap time.
Parrots. There are actual parrots. There's a parrot Pokemon now. Or are they macaws? Oh, whatever. It's a new type of burb. Now saving. Get up. Oh, those are awesome stickers. I like those. All right. Yeah, let me go into options. I'm going to turn autosave off just to be on the safe side. Here it is. Show nickname, show, skip cutscenes. I want that off. I'm going to turn down the music just a little bit. Helping functions. I'll keep those on. Skip move learning. I never really had an opportunity to check all the options on my own file. You can choose not to be prompted to teach your Pokemon new moves as soon as they level up. And there's my computer. Or there's my, Oh my god, I'm getting a phone call. Is that... Oh my god. A phone call interrupted the... Oh god. Well, it was from the healthcare marketplace because healthcare in this country sucks. My records show you haven't picked a plan for next year. Blah, blah, blah. Anyway. So I didn't have a good opportunity to check all the options on my own file. I just basically went through and lowered the volume on a couple of these and then moved on. Let's also give ourselves fast. Did they do away with heart scales completely? Or was that in the last gen? I don't know. Anyway. Yeah, tech speed fast, skip move learning off. Send to boxes. Yeah, I'll do that. I'll do automatic. Yeah. All right, we have saved our settings. It's a new Nintendo Switch system. This one's got a bigger screen. It's the OLED. I have the launch Switch. I've had to replace the fan in it already. Oh my god, it's a Squova cushion. Also, you can move the camera around a little bit indoors. That's neat. We have a pet Squova. Muncha! Yay! It's the house, Squovit. Good morning, Vickles! Oh, already in your uniform and everything. Well, it is your first day at your new school, after all. I'm so excited for you. Still, you might want to cool your engines before you go racing out the door. School contacted me and said that you're supposed to wait here a little while longer. Their words, not mine. Apparently, there's something very important for your first day that still hasn't arrived. Huh, speak of the devil, I wonder what that could be. Maybe that's the very thing we were waiting for. Fickles, get the door, would you? If I have to change the location of the webcam later on, I will. If it's blocking important stuff. Do forgive the intrusion. You are Miss Vickles, yes? On behalf of the Academy, I must apologize for the late arrival of your enrollment documents. Ah, and also for my delay in introducing myself. I am the director of Naranja Academy. You may call me Mr. Clavel. Hmm. I'm gonna make a prediction. He's evil. I don't know if that's right or not. I haven't played that far on my personal file. But that's my prediction. If it's wrong, then I'm wrong. The director? And you came in person to help my daughter with her first day? Reason being, he's got 6 Pokeballs on his waist and they're all Premier Balls. That's my only reasoning. Well, I am responsible for the entire academy, including any failures on its part. So, here at last are the enrollment documents that should have already been delivered to you. I guess the delivery company is having setbacks. Goodness, you really needn't have. Since you've come all this way, can I at least offer you a cup of tea? No need to trouble yourself. Vickles, I've got a thing or two to discuss with the director here. Why don't you head back up to your room and finish getting ready for school? You'll need your bag and your hat as well. Now, Mr. Clavel, you simply must join me for a cuppa. This way. Well, how can I review such a kind offer? Is our mom single and trying to get into... Anyway. Yes, let's go on ahead and change. Oh, now our pack is sparkling like it's telling us to put it on. Ready to put on your hat and grab your bag? I put on my wizard robe and hat. Oh God, speaking of my robe, it is a little chilly right now. It has been unusually cold the past few days. Work has been a bitch. There's been a couple times where I've seen my breath indoors, just because of the nature of work. You can press the X button to open the main menu, select the save option, blah 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 blah. And now I have access to the bag. We have our medicines, our Pokeballs, our battle items, our berries, other items, TMs, TM materials, because apparently you can craft TMs in this game, treasures, picnic items, key items, actual medicine, knickknacks, paddywhacks, give a dog a bone. And the hoarding pocket, where you hoard everything that you simply don't want to throw away because you think it might be useful later on in your life, and then you just build up a bunch of clutter in your house, and then your relatives have to get rid of it after you die. Yes, the uniform of our storied academy suits you quite well indeed. Oh, gracious, how very careless of me. I had entirely forgotten that I've something else for you, Miss Fickles. Most important thing. But your living room is hardly the place for it. Would you care to follow me outside? Please get me away from your mother. She's been so trying hard to pit on me. I wonder if what this important thing might be. Let's follow the director out and see, shall we? I'll go first! Have you told your mother that I'm married? Right then, dear Pokemon, time to come out of your Pokeballs. Oh, what? You thought I was gonna give you one of the Pokeballs that were around my waist? How naive are you? We provide each student entering the academy a Pokemon of their own. I'll ask you to choose which among these three you'd like to have as your partner. Sprigatito, the grass cat Pokemon. Fuecoco, the no thoughts head empty Pokemon. And Quaxly, the brains of Fuecoco. They're all very good company. Why, they usually refuse to even leave my side. Fuecoco is literally just no thoughts head empty. What's this? So it turns out they're more interested in you, Miss Fickles, than familiar old me. I do wish I could stay and see which one you'll choose, but I must be off to my next home visit. I'll be at the house just over there. Take your time with your decision, then come find me once your mind is made up. Now, if you'll excuse me, until next we meet. Which will be over there at the house. What a mannerly fellow that director of yours is. These three are all lovely, but you need to choose just one, right? Not an easy task. Why not take this opportunity to walk about with these little ones and get to know them? I'm sure they have lots to teach you. Oh, but before you go, I got you a little something to celebrate your big day. Take it with you if you're going out on your own. You obtained a smartphone. You put your phone in your bags item, key items pocket. The latest model of smartphone, a Pokemon called iRotom, lives within it, and it can be used to run all sorts of happy, handy apps. I guess they can be happy too. It's a brand new phone. According to the instructions, you can check the map app by pressing the Y button. I mean, yeah, there are ads because it's the free version, but I'm a cheapskate. Now, off you go. Have fun. And in order to get a full high-definition version of the map, you'll need to actually pay for it, but whatever. You'll be fine. I wonder if there's anything over here. I actually never really took the chance to look around over here. Oh! What's this? That's a potion. Oh, okay, they're also over here. He's adorable and I love him, but I already know which one I'm picking. Oh, look at that, another item. Jeez. I really missed a lot when I started out. Antidote, cool. Where are they? Oh, they're over here, okay. Well, I picked up all the trash around the house. I'm around the yard. I'm sure Mom will appreciate that. Hold on a second. Okay. What have you found, guy? Or are you just wandering around trying to just exist? Cabo Poco. Oh, now I can run. This is Cabo Poco. It's not much, just a little pinch of community, but it's home. You do know I live here, right? Oh, is it the time? The power of science is amazing! If you connect with your friends, you can head out on adventures together, up to four of you at a time! Yep, it's that time again. So yeah, items are easier to find on the map now because it's open world, because they make them glow on the map, and I think these first few items are preset, but the rest of them I think might be randomized? I know they keep on respawning. Oh. Oh, okay, you guys are already over here. Trying to figure out which plants it wants to bite.
Hey, I found a fruit!
And it's burnt.
Maybe I can still eat it.
Are you these three's trainer?
Not quite. Miss Fickles has yet to make her choice, you see.
I do wonder which of them she will choose for her first Pokemon.
Oh, you.
And that's why Quaxly is the brains of Fuecoco. And that's why I'm picking Sprigatito, because I don't know what Fuecoco would do without Quaxly around to make sure it doesn't die.
Wait us. We haven't met, have we?
I must say, I wasn't expecting to see you here quite so soon. Well, you did say come over when I'm ready.
Hang on, Director, is this who I think it is?
Yes, this is our Academy's newest student, Miss Fickles. Miss Fickles, she will be attending as of today.
So you're that kid who moved in up the road. Time to give you a Harry Potter complex. I've been dying to find out more about you.
I'm Nimona. Normally I live in the school dorms, but home is here. What do you say, new neighbor? Want to be friends? You know what? Screw it. I need all the help I can get.
Miss Nimona is president of our student council and a champion-ranked trainer in her own right. I absolutely love Pokemon battling. In fact, we should battle right now, you and me.
Easy now. You two will be in the same class, so you'll have plenty of time to battle later. And get to know one another better, of course.
We're going to be neighbors and classmates? Nice. We'll be able to battle all we want.
On that note, Miss Fickles, have you decided which of these Pokemon you would like to be your first partner?
I've already chosen this one.
Fire!
I'm choosing the grass kitty. Sprigatito. I've named the one on my personal file El Cato. Would you like to give Sprigatito a nickname? Yes, I would. I shall name you... I was going to say Scat because Sprigatito cat, but that's... No. What should I name Sprigatito for this file? Grasshole? Nah. I honestly don't know. Oh, I got it. Normal. Cause it kind of reminds me of Normal from the Garfield comics.
Yay, I have Kitty.
Which automatically locks me out of any other grass types I want to have in my party for the entire game.
Sprigatito seems to have taken quite a liking to you, Miss Fickles. This is your first Pokemon, yes? Please, raise it with love and care. And of course, be sure to keep it tucked safely inside a Pokeball. And it's gone.
Fickles, I can't believe you actually chose Sprigatito. I mean, like... Way to make the perfect choice for you. You two make such a good combo.
I bet you say that for any of them.
Can I choose one of these Pokemon too, Director Clavel?
Oh, but did you not receive a Pokemon when you entered the Academy, Miss Nimona?
Not back then, no. I had other Pokemon I was focused on raising at the time, but now I want to raise a new Pokemon alongside Vickles while she raises her own partner.
Indeed, a rather splendid idea. If you wish to raise one of these Pokemon on equal footing with Miss Fickles here, I shall be more than happy to allow it.
Yes! I get to min-max my own personal team!
And she chooses the one that's weak to ours.
Now that we've chosen our Pokemon, we have to battle.
Well, I pray for Fuecoco to stay alive. In the care of the headmaster there. Yep, there goes Fuecoco's brain.
As you may have noticed, Miss Nimona is a tad overly fond of Pokemon battling. But I do hope you'll join her for a battle. It will help you to get to know your own Pokemon as well.
All right. Well, we can go around for a little bit. Well, you're forever going to have no thoughts. Your head is permanently empty. All right, there's a potion. Should be something down this way. Yeah, okay. Oh, there's something over here, too. Another potion! I'm doing this so I don't have to go to the... So I don't have to buy a whole lot from the shop. Antidote. An item over there. There's an item up there that I can't get to yet. Another potion. And, something over here. Nope. I know exactly where to go, but I'm just going around and just grabbing as much stuff as I can. Ooh, there might be an item on that cliff. I'm gonna go up there. Over here! I know! You can wait another minute while I go and collect items so I can make my life as easy as possible. Oh! Actually, I'm gonna move the webcam. Because the mini-map is right there. There we go. And I believe there's one more item over this way that I can get immediately. Another potion. So that puts the auto heal. And it uses up these in that order. Okay. Go to bag. I've got 5 potions, 2 antidotes, and 3 Pokeballs. I found a total of 10 items before the first rival fight. All right. Bag. Actually, go to the Pokemon. Check summary. 19 HP. Kind of low. Up attack, low special defense. So it's going to be a physical attacker. Which kind of sucks because I have a special grass attack. But I think we definitely do get a physical grass move at some point, so it's not going to be all bad. Anyone can be a Pokemon trainer as long as they have a Pokemon by their side, and it's our duty as trainers to help our Pokemon grow stronger through battle. So, you ready to battle me? If it gets the story along. Perfecto! I'm so excited for this battle. I think I'll use... Miss Nimona? I trust you remember that Miss Vickles is wholly inexperienced in Pokemon battling. Oh, how little you know me. Whoops, good call, Director. I was about to send off one of my usual partners right off the bat. I guess I'll take this chance to try out my new buddy instead. It's basically her way of saying, listen here, little punk, I can kick your ass at any time. Come on, Vickles, let's have a fruitful battle. And remember, I'm better than you. The only reason you're going to be able to beat me is if I bring myself down to your level. All right. Cat versus bird. Quaxly is pure water type, but does not have any flying to it, so... Yeah. Ow!
Take that! You must have been studying up. Smart move. Grass is strong against water. You know about type weaknesses. She's a champion Reich student. Yay, I leveled up and I beat a trainer. Now give me your lunch money. Thank you. Look at you, winning your first battle ever. You've got even more potential than I thought. You're gonna be a strong trainer for sure. But now I just want to try a different strategy. Let's go again, just one more battle. You mean the strategy where you don't use a move that's strong, that's not very effective against mine? Oh, come on, I wanted to go best 2 out of 3 against her. Miss Fickles and her Spurgatitles sure are surely wearily already from that last battle. Ah, no, my cat can keep going. Sorry, I kind of got caught up in the excitement. I'm really sorry, Vickle. Same to your Sprigatito, too. Nah, don't worry about it. I've been playing since the very beginning. You two have no idea. Can I count on you to take your new schoolmate to here under your wing, Miss Nimona? I'm sure she can learn a great deal from a champion-ranked trainer such as yourself. Oh, is that what you think? Oh, that reminds me. Since you're new to training Pokemon, there's an app you definitely... Oh, that's Nimona talking. Don't you guys have phones? Let me see it. I just downloaded a Pokedex app. I was about to reach for my phone, but it's being used for the webcam. The Pokedex will automatically register any Pokemon you catch. It's a must-have app for Pokemon trainers. It's a super handy app. Our homeroom teacher, Mr. Jock, actually made it himself. If you like it, please rate it 5 stars so it'll appear in the algorithm. Back in my day, we used ordinary paper and handwritten notes to compile our Pokedexes. And we liked it, dagnabbit! Ooh, filling out a Pokedex by hand? Man, you're old, mister. Oh, you wound me. Yet no matter how much times may change, the wonder of meeting new Pokemon never does. Yeah, it is truly a timeless pleasure.
What's going on? Where am I?
And the more Pokemon that you encounter, the more you'll find yourself growing and changing. I hope you both will work hard toward the goal of completing your own Pokedexes.
What? Technically, wouldn't she be a bit closer since she's a champion ranked student?
Now, Miss Nimona, I do still have a few matters to discuss with your parents. Could I depend on you to see Miss Fickles to the academy? You would be doing me quite the favor.
Of course, leave it to me.
Then I leave her in your capable hands. All right, little one, it's time you and I were on our way. I'll need to find you a new brain.
I.e. a new Quaxley.
Maybe I ought to make a little more time to work on my Pokedex along with all my battling.
Oh, right. Speaking of Pokedexes, Fickles, you've probably never caught a wild Pokemon, right?
I'll show you the ropes before I take you to the academy with a forced tutorial. Come with me.
It's actually not that bad.
Press the minus button to open the Pokedex. You can also navigate to your Pokedex by pressing the X button from the map app. Your Rotom phone! Oh, okay, there it is. Loading, Pokedex. Battle or catch Pokemon to compile volumes in the Pokedex app with fancier covers for Pokemon you've caught. Open up your Pokedex to view, and you can see locations. Yeah, let's see.
So yeah, they the Pokedex is kind of different in this game, where there's actually some nice little portraits for each Pokemon that you catch. Its fluffy fur is similar in composition to plants. This Pokemon frequently washes its face to keep it from drying out. Oh. So it has dry skin as its hidden ability? Oh, profile. Total playtime, 30 minutes. Recipes collected. Oh, it keeps track of shiny Pokemon. And then the Paldea Pokedex and badges collected. Okay. Cool. I have actually not looked at my profile on my personal file yet. That was the first time I've done that. Oh, I can actually enter her house. Oh, there's some Pachirisu and a Chansey. Oh my god. Pachirisu is adorable. I'm guessing her family is rich. Because they employ workers. Where does dust come from? I find it just as baffling as the things that Pokemon can do. It's dead skin. Which is why computers tend to be very dusty if you use them practically all day for work. Goomy! And Gibble. Ah, another No Thoughts Head empty Pokemon. Same thing with Totodile and Sandile. Basically any croc Pokemon in this game. Just, they have that look that says No Thoughts Head empty. And if it weren't for the fact that I like the Grass Cat more, I probably would be going with Fuecoco. Just because of that vacant look. I love it. My apologies. Both the master and the mistress of the house are away at present. Do be careful on the way to school, Miss Fickles. So, I guess I... Oh my god, that's an amazing portrait. The painting is titled Sibling Love. It's pretty charming. That has a lot of different meanings, you know. All right, so yeah, let's actually go. Hey, I actually didn't know you were a rich kid. I hear that Nimona here will be taking you to school, yes? That's right, ma'am, leave it to me. So you've already managed to make a friend. And I've read all about the wonderful teachers you'll have looking after you at the school. Plus, so many handy facilities you can use as much as you like. Add in your new friend, Nimona, and it sounds like your school life is shaping up to be fantastic, which will put a lot less stress on me, which means I can actually do whatever I want now. And I no longer have crushed dreams. Now, you'll be staying in the school dorm, so I want you to promise me you'll eat proper meals. Instead of going out for every single meal because you didn't learn how to cook from me because, goddamn, I tried so hard, but you just wouldn't take. Here's a bit of spending money to start off with because I know how terrible you are at managing your finances. And a sandwich. Oh, and maybe you better take these too. They're not for your Pokemon, they're for you. I know how clumsy you are. Use them on that precious little partner of yours. Or yourself, because I know you have a tendency to fall off cliffs. Foreshadowing is a mechanic you... Foreshadowing is a storytelling device.
Wow, it sounds like your mom's. It sounded like your mom was joyous when she was giving you all that stuff. It's almost like she has all the free time in the world now that you're out of the house forever.
Oh, but I was going to teach you how to catch wild Pokemon. Come on, vamos. This way.
There we go. I can move.
Pokopath.
All right, this here is Pokopath. Look at those round boys. Both the spiders and the pigs. Out here, things are a little different than in 10. You're gonna see wild Pokemon out and about. They'll be on the path in the grass and such. Get too close to one and you'll have to battle, but you've got Sprigatito for that, right? And if you want to try to catch a Pokemon, you got to use these. A good old Pokeball. I've got tons. Here, have some more to add to the ones you already found before you battled me. So that brings our total up to 8. Oink, oink. Oh, what luck. Seems my pig call actually called a Pokemon to help you battle so you learn how to catch Pokemon, even though you've already learned how to catch them for over 25 years. Yeah, yeah. So we can technically catch it. I cannot escape. So, okay, so this one is forced. Want to see if I can knock it out. I don't want this Lechonk. Oh, no, I did too much damage to it. Oh, well. Nice. Defeating Pokemon in battle will help Sprigatito grow and get stronger. Next time, try throwing a Pokeball when a Pokemon's right on the tip of being defeated. You'll have a decent chance at catching it then. Oh, I know that. I was just depending on ranges and all that stuff. Yeah, totally. I was gonna catch that one. Anyway, have some more Pokeballs just in case. Not every catch works out. So now we have 18. Weaken the Pokemon, then throw it. So yeah, you don't necessarily have to catch the Pokemon in the catch tutorial. You can defeat it and have something else as your first catch. Or you can choose not to catch any and wait until you're in the next area. Head to the lighthouse. At this point, you're free to roam about this little area here, collect items, and catch as many or none of the Pokemon. Oh, I almost got up there. There we go. Another Pokeball. Oh, wow. A revive just like that. Pokeball. Alright, I'm not going to catch a bird on this route either. I want one of those flamingos. That's going to be my bird Pokemon. And if you're wondering about how berries are found, there's actually little glints on the ground. If you find one of those, just approach it and then pick it up. It doesn't show you which one is on the ground. It'll tell you what it is when you actually catch it. Oh, there's a Palmy. It's a tiny little mouse.
Alright, so... Oh, a little bug. Do I want to try to raise a Vivillon? Probably not. And just when you think you've caught the last Pokemon in the area, well, there's another one around the corner. Actually, I'll tell you right now that Flamingo Pokemon is flying fighting, so there might be another fighting Pokemon I have in mind. So I may go on ahead and catch a Fletchling here. Hey, Vickles, you're getting the hang of how to catch Pokemon, okay? Let me see, so far you've caught a mysterious cry all of a sudden. To hide the shame of me not catching any. I've never heard that kind of cry before. Could be some strong Pokemon or something. I say we find whatever made that cry. Let's take a look around, Vickles. Just be careful. There's a kind of unsafe cave not far from here, so steer clear. And I know your Rotom phone can help you keep you safe, but watch your step by the cliffs anyway. Find the source of the mysterious cry, or just go this way. Alright, I'm actually gonna come up here. I thought I heard something. That is... Oh, it's a young goose! Huh, didn't know they were out here as well. I was hoping for a different Pokemon to show up here. But oh well. Let's see. What is your level? Also, those, the yellow glow are TMs. Just think of the yellow Pokeball items from previous games. And that's what they are. There we go. That's the level type of level I was looking for. And scratch. Ooh, nice. Shake your little money maker, pig. Lechonk! And yes, I'm gonna raise a Lechonk. Hey, I got Bite! The Hog Pokemon. It searches for food all day. It possesses a keen sense of smell, but doesn't use it for anything other than foraging. Yes, I would! I'm gonna call you Lepork. And that's the animation for when you register a Pokemon to your Pokedex. And defeating a wild Pokemon or catching it nets you material you can use to make TMs. I'm gonna go on ahead and battle you. I'm actually not gonna raise one of these since I raised one until it evolved on my personal file just to see what it looked like. It has a weird looking evolution. I'm just going to say that much. It actually does get a decent bug move early on, though. Like, not long after you catch one. That is a scatterbug. I do not want that. Whee! Leafage! Keep on using leafage. Many more of leafage.
Hoppip. Oops. Didn't mean to get that close. But yeah, there are wild Hoppip. Very early on. I don't know why you would want to raise a Hoppip if you didn't get a grass starter. I don't really consider it a very good Pokemon, even as a Jumpluff. Do I want to raise a Palmy? Because it's an electric type. And that might actually be good. Why not? Let's try raising one for the stream file. I'm actually going to go to the other Palmy and see what level it is. So I'm going to defeat this one for sure. Nice. Palmiver. Oh, and a neat little feature about changing positions of your Pokemon. There's a dedicated put into the lead button. So you no longer have to press button multiple times to move them. You can, if you want them up at the front, there's a dedicated button for that now. And I really like that quality of life change. All right, other Palmy. Let's battle you. See what level you are. You are... Oh, I picked the right one. Oh. And you're faster. And you're going to kill me in one more hit. Swap. Oh, now you decide to use a non-attacking move. Well, just for that, I'm going to scratch you. Don't paralyze. Okay, good. Nice. All right, so I was right in catching the second one. Nice. Disarming voice. Okay, cool. The mouse Pokemon. It has underdeveloped egg sacs on its cheeks. These sacs can produce electricity only if Palmy rubs them furiously with the pads on its forepaws. Yes, I would. It's not a Pikachu. All right, let's check your summary. Looks like it's more physically oriented, so I'm hoping it gets a physical electric move like Spark. Hasty by nature, so up speed. Ooh, it's not going to be very defensive then. It's got a good speed, though. So it's definitely going to be swift, and it's going to strike hard. All right. Going to put the stab move up here. Going to put that right there. And it's not a Pikachu. All right. LeChonk. Got disarming voice. What's, so it's fairly balanced at the moment. Yeah. It never misses. Okay, so we've got a good move to stop accuracy spammers. You become fire flying for your final evolution. Hello. Impressed? Oh, I can actually do it in this game too. Okay, you don't pose at the end of it, but okay, you do the thing that people expect you to do after you're done spinning in place. All right, Lepork. I'm gonna see if there's a higher level one, because I don't want to catch another level three. Ow. Ow. Oops. See what the level of the next one is. And if it's higher, I'll catch it. Otherwise. Oh. So yeah, this is a berry. Or it's a potion. Every single one of those that I found on my personal file has been a berry, so that was unexpected. Hello. I want to battle you. Oh, it's level two. Ooh. All right, you're just experience fodder then. Oh, that's a Hoppip over there. Hey, you're level six. Fletchling Feather. I need another Fletchling. They're definitely around. Found you. Hello. I want level 4 or 5, please. Hey, that works. God, I really need to get around to shaving. Hell, I need to get around to getting a friggin' haircut. I haven't been to a barber in 4-5 months. There we go. All right, should be weak enough. I will train the Gen 6 flying Pokemon. Starting flying Pokemon. There we are. Tiny Robin. This Pokemon is normally calm, but once it enters battle, its hormonal balance changes and it becomes aggressive. Oh, good. Well, that means it's a little firecracker. All right, we have 4 Pokemon on our team. I'm not going to catch any more for the party. Oh, With the abundance of flying Pokemon, with the abundance of bug Pokemon around, that means it's going to be easy to level up this thing. So yeah, let's kick the ass of some Scatterbugs and some Tyroundchulas. String shot. Oh, I should have caught it. I would have gotten the experience a little faster. I'll do that for the next one. Oops. I need to rearrange those moves. Oh, good. There we go. All right, Scatterbug has been caught. Oh, nice. Hey, quick attack. Good. Any poison this Pokemon takes in is converted into a black powder and secreted. That's why Scatterbug can eat poisonous leaves and roots. No. Any Pokemon I don't nickname, I'm not going to consider for the party. Or I could just keep the next two Pokemon I catch in my team and take them out when they've fully evolved. I think you get to Vivillon at a very early level. So it wouldn't be too bad if I keep Scatterbug in the team. And I like how the music stops because the next story beat happened. Alright. I'm gonna go after this one and then I gotta rearrange those moves. I'll go after this Pokemon and then one more, and then I'll go on ahead and continue with the story. Haha, joke's on you. I have Quick Attack. There we go. Oh, hi. I had an audience. All right, and yeah, I'm gonna catch this one. Tyroundchula. Oh, perfect. I also like the speed at which the shakes happen because it means you're not waiting around too long. Hey, not Pikachu learned a physical move. The ball of threads wrapped around its body is elastic enough to deflect the scythe of Scyther, this Pokemon's natural enemy. I would not. Add it to the party. I know when you evolve and it is a little while off, so I may go on ahead and just take you out of the party. Go to boxes. And relegate you there. Okay. Oh, there's a Sparkly. There we go. Chestoberry. That's what was supposed to happen. I'm I'm gonna keep leading with Firecracker. Didn't mean to do that. Heal up my Pokemon. I was holding on to the B button, which is a crouch. All right, here we go.
Where'd that come from? No. 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 Oh, there it is.
Oh, it's getting harassed by a couple of Houndour.
Gyah!
That's not how you say Yu-Gi-Oh. Oh god. And apparently our phone is also a parachute. Because logic. Any items around? Nope. Oh, you aren't looking too hot. The mysterious Pokemon seems to be too weak to move. Maybe you can give it something to help it perk up? Hey, this is the sandwich our mom gave that became a key item. I wonder what happens if we use it.
Is that vegetables? Meat, veggie, spread.
Smells nice. You gave it the sandwich and your hand. Well, looks like it liked it.
Now I can get out of here. Well, you're on your own, kid. Bye!
I heard a Wingull in the background. It's converting the sandwich into energy to transform! Oh! Well, it looks like it is, it's turned Super Saiyan. I guess I just follow behind it slowly and we'll be okay? Well, I can't access my menu, so I guess, yeah, just keep going. Inlet Grotto. I can't get ahead of it. It'll just default me to walking speed if I get too close. And there are also items. I'm wondering if I can pick them up. Oh, there's one right here. All right, yeah, I can pick up items. Oi, Vickles! There you are, Vickles. You okay? You're not hurt, right? I'm fine. Thank goodness, I was really worried.
Imagine what your mother would do if something happened to you while you were under my wing. No, never mind that. Right now, we gotta focus on getting you back up here. You just gotta find some way to climb out of there. If you get close enough, I'll try pulling you up with one of my Pokemon's moves. I think I can I can handle that on my own. What's that Pokemon in front of you? It looks super strong. Kind of seems like it's waiting for you. Oh! It, broke through. Whoa, that was amazing! That Pokemon might be as strong as mine. Even though we can't access our menu, we can still get into Pokemon battles and catch things. So I'm gonna catch a couple of Pokemon. You can find Yungoos, Diglett, and if you get lucky, you might be able to catch a Houndour in here. I know for a fact that in that little area where we found the Yungoos in the on the field, Houndour can spawn there. And I actually managed to catch one for my team on my personal file. So yeah, let's catch this one. Just for the Pokedex. Nice. Its stomach fills most of its torso. It wanders the same path every day, searching for fresh food. Nah. All right, I'm good. Let's go. Also, there's just a Houndoom right there. Diglett! Oh, I can't get ahead of it no matter what. Quick attack. Don't kill! Okay. Yay. Level up. It lives about 1 yard underground where it feeds on plant roots. It sometimes appears above ground. Sometimes on its own. Sometimes in a group of three fingers. Diglett dirt. Alright, I'm just gonna go this way real quick. Don't mind me. Oh, I gotta wait for you to go up that way. Okay. Ooh, two Pokeballs. Alright, cool. Made up for the ones that I used to catch those two Pokemon. Then we get... Oh, those two Houndour went to go get its friends. And then they get scared and run off. Alright, I saw an item over here. I'm gonna get it. Hey, heads up, some pretty rough and rowdy Houndour live down there. Here we go. Slash. Nice. Oh my gosh, it straight up pulverized that rock. How the hell are you seeing this? What's over here? Oh, is that the way we came? It is. Fickles, look out, something's coming! Ow. Behind you! It's behind you! Oh, it's the Houndoom we saw earlier. Doom!
It can't be that bad, can it? Let's go.
There's no way you could run from this opponent.
Really? It didn't even give me a chance to pick a move. Yeah, that's a reasonable reaction from the Pokemon. Just run away on its own. Oh. Oh god, it's a stampede. It's a stampede of angry doggos. And even more. It realizes that the wisest course of action is to just get the hell out of there. Up here, quick! Ah! Can you put me down now? I don't like to be carried like a sack of potatoes. I get plenty of that on Final Fantasy XIV as my stabby potato. Way to go! For a second, I thought you were both goners! Oh, hey, look! It's the lighthouse. Nope, and it ran out of energy.
Narcolepsy.
Maybe it used up all its power? What is this Pokemon anyway? It kind of looks like a Cyclizar, but I've never seen one quite like this before. And now it looks so different from a minute ago. You think it's okay? I don't know. You can't tell either, huh, Vickles? Well, all that aside, I'm seriously glad to have you back up here in one piece. Your mother would kill me if something happened to you. You know, that battle down there was really something. You and this fellow looked perfectly in sync facing down that Houndoom. Why, you didn't even tell it what to do? Oh god, my hands feel dry. Cold weather saps the moisture out of my hands super easily. And these past few days have been torture for my friggin' hands. God. I need to get some better gloves for work, honestly. Ugh. Thinking I might bring a bottle of hand lotion to work with me so I can try to keep the moisturized, but ugh. Oh good, it looks like it perked up a little bit. Do you think this fella was the one making that mysterious cry we heard before? Kinda sounded like it. Gia Gaios! Oh man, oh man, oh man, the more I look at this Pokemon, the more mysterious it seems! If you do become its trainer, you gotta let me battle against it. Let's exchange numbers so we can get in touch if we somehow get separated again. Ah, you've got a black phone case. Cool. And here, this will let you teach your Pokemon a move to help it battle stronger opponents. Hey, I got Swift. Star-shaped rays are shot at the opposing Pokemon. This attack never misses. I don't think you'll need to bother making any of that TM because I've found like two or three on the field. You've both been through enough for a minute. I think we better take a breather. Let's just get to the lighthouse. That'll be a good spot to relax. Your Pokedex has been updated. The list of TMs you can make at the TM machine has been updated. All right, and look here on the map. It's in this area. It looks like there's some swarms of these Pokemon. Cool. You doing okay, guy?
Yeah.
I think it wants another sandwich from me. Hey! Oh wow, an actual Oranberry. We're back out here. Okay, yeah, that's what I thought. Actually, the health of my Pokemon are just fine. I'm gonna go on ahead and let you go up front. Is it gonna let me go behind the lighthouse? Nope. Why that little? What are you doing out here? I'm not talking to you two. You can shove off. Wait, I know you. Aren't you Arvin? You're enrolled in the humanities track, right? And aren't you the son of that Pokemon researcher, Professor Sada? Doesn't matter who my mom is. Wow, I like him already. The real issue here is what in the world this Pokemon is doing out here? What is with this form it's in? It saved me from a tight spot. See, we heard the strange cry and we tried to investigate, but Vickles fell off a cliff. That Pokemon saved her, but it seems like it wore itself out in the process. It got kind of slumpy afterward. But you should have seen it before. It looked totally different. It was unbelievably strong. Well, yes, it should be, but it can't fight while it's like this. The form Koridon takes in battle, that's its true form. Koridon, is that this Pokemon's name? How'd you know it?
Agiga! Agigias!
You can't go in the lab, it's locked. I don't remember ever seeing you around, but given the uniform, you go to the academy too, do you? Koridon isn't the sort of Pokemon that any old trainer can hope to command, it's special. Special how? What sort of Pokemon is it? You think you're up to ordering Koridon around? Then how about it test your worthiness? You know what? I don't like your bedside manner. Let's go on ahead and kick your ass. Feeling out of all sorts, so I'm gonna use this battle to blast these doldrums away. Love it! Go la pork! These memories are leaving a bad taste in my mouth and I want it gone. Oh wow! A level 5 Squovet. Oh boy, I'm shaking. And he's down. Young Goose learned Leer! I should probably put that at back in the box. Suri! Seems you know a thing or two about battle. And now I got his lunch of money. Wow, Vickles, that was awesome. I guess I wasn't ever going to stand a chance at using some old Pokemon I'd only just caught. But if you really think you can take Koridon off my hands for me, you'll need this. It's the Pokeball that Brute's been kept in. Oh. And it's a key item. It looks like a Pokeball. So why'd you have it? Anyway, that thing's your problem now, not mine. Good luck. Yeah, first impression of him is not very stellar, is it? What a weirdo.
I gave him a sandwich and now he thinks I'm his new best friend. That Arvin guy definitely knows more than he's letting on. Next time he and I are battling, I'm gonna wring out some answers from him. Oh, but right, we gotta climb the lighthouse. Can't wait to show you the view of our school. Alright, well, I'll be along shortly. I gotta go around here and grab an item. Another revive. Oh, by the way, you can go back down there later. And there are gonna be there's gonna be a lot of Houndour down there too that you can catch, so it's not a one-and-done area. Otherwise, you'd never be able to get that TM that was next to Houndoom. Let's see if there's anything else over here. Oh! Couple of Wingull. Oh, I can have it out. Okay, cool. Look, Vickles, that's Mesagoza. And that huge building with the Pokeball on it is our school. Wow. That's a place. It's gonna be so great having you in the same class, Vickles. But all that schoolwork. Now I'm looking forward to it. Right, I can't wait to get back. We're gonna get to learn so much and battle so much. Isn't it awesome what you can see from up here? Mountains, forests, scrapslands, beautiful nature stuff as far as the eye can see. And you know what's waiting for you all over these natural spaces? Tons of Pokemon. Consider this me officially telling you, welcome to Paldea. But anyway, like you can see, it's kind of a hike to get to school from here. Let's make it to Los Platos for starters. That's right on the way. Vamos, come on! Oh, and fun fact, after that battle against that guy, our Pokemon got fully healed. Let me go on ahead and move these into the... Let me move Young Goose into the box. Oh! Would you like to go back to where you were before you fell? Why'd it put me back up there? Oh, hi. I thought it meant over next to the cliff. Okay. Oops. Strange wording, but okay. Also, weird that... Okay. I guess it's considered part of the area. Also, I'm actually impressed by the variety of Pokemon that you can find in the areas just before you get to the school. Like, there's Psyduck, Azurill, there's Wingull and Magikarp and Weasel. And there's also a Wigglet down this way. Yeah, there's a bunch of, there's also a bunch of fairy types, a bunch of grass, couple of grass types. The variety of Pokemon that you can find in the first little areas here is just amazing. So you could pretty much put together a semi-decent team right away. So yeah, if you're wondering if you can catch Wigglet early on, yeah, you can.
Aww. Didn't mean to do that. Ow. You actually gotta go a little slow approaching them, because they will go under if you are running toward them. There we go. Oh, that's a neat little detail. Ow. I'm probably not going to put Wigglet on my team. I've got it on my team in my personal file. I'm thinking I may go with a different water type. Sand attack all you want. It's not going to matter because of disarming voice. But I will catch this thing. Also, the music for the open areas is super good, which kind of makes sense because Toby Fox helped make a lot of the music for the feel for a lot of the areas in the game. Nah. There's also Weasel, there's Magikarp, Wingull. That, fun fact, they actually walk like that on the ground. I did not know that. Wow, it's level 6. Disarming voice, then. Ah, it squirted water at me. Three, done. Yay, I caught Wingull. Fletchling leveled up. All right. No, I would not. Yep, that's Magikarp, all right. Oh, wow, it jumped over me. Yeah, let's go on ahead and catch this thing. Garp, garp, garp. Hey, look at that. I've got a little audience. Yeah. All right, Scatterbug learned Stun Spore. Ooh. An underpowered, pathetic Pokemon. It may jump high on rare occasions, but never more than 7 feet. Rude? Magikarp is a very fine, majestic Pokemon. It's just not going to be on my team. Because I'm trying not to have a lot of overlap between types. And if I were to have a Gyarados, that would mean it'd be conflicting with my Cinderace. My Talonflame, rather. That's a good thing I'm using Disarming Voice.
Keep going, LeChonk. You can do it.
There we go. Weasel was caught. Nice.
Echoed voice. Cool.
It spins its two tails like a screw to propel itself through water. The tails also slice clinging seaweed.
Oh, nice.
There we are. There's also Psyduck up this way, so I think I'll catch one as I go back up.
You could just stay in this little area for hours and you would be perfectly fine.
Which is what I'm gonna try to not do when I'm streaming this. Because I'm just tempted to just stay here and just keep on battling the various water types that are on that beach.
If this move is used consecutively by any Pokemon, its power is boosted.
Ah. But it's also stab. But because LeChonk has higher physical, I think? Tackle's gonna do a little more damage. Oh, that was critical. Oh, wow. It's got confusion this early.
There we go.
I wonder if there's a regional evolution for Psyduck. Like there's a Paldean Golduck or something that would add psychic typing. Because you would think that Psyduck would be part psychic. Because it has confusion and it can learn psychic.
Oh, God, I love that.
Paralyze heal. Oh, yeah, let me go on ahead and restore the health of my Pokemon. Restore health. There we are.
Now, I've yet to catch one of these bad boys, so I'm going to.
I think this thing is bulky. Yeah. Oh, wow. Bubble Beam. Too bad it didn't do much. Oh. So, it's still got Splash. All right.
There we go.
Throw the ball. Catch the Pokemon. Win the experience. Yay.
Nice. Hone Claws.
Attack and accuracy. Because it's got higher attack, that might actually be a good idea. I don't think I learned that on my personal files, Brigatito.
Either that or I skipped it. I don't remember.
No. Thank you. X defense. Don't mind me, just passing through. Alright, there's this very specific area I want to try to get to now.
I'll just collect items as I go.
Pokeball. Ooh, a bunch of Hoppip. Paralyze heal. I think there's an item up here. Ooh. There we are. X accuracy. Wow. Go back up. No. Ooh. There's a happening nearby. And... protect. Another TM. Oh, don't fall down accidentally. Ooh, struggle bug. Okay, it stopped me. It stopped me. We're good. Paralyze heal. All right, so over here. No. Here it is. I want to swap to you. Oh, it's right here. All right, let's go. It is called Flamigo. It is fighting flying, which means it takes a lot of, it's weak to its own, one of its own types. And also, it has a weird property about it whenever you catch one or defeat one. It gives out a boatload of experience. Not Pikachu wants to learn charge, no. Yeah, it has a boat, it gives a boatload of experience, which kind of tells me it does not have an evolution. Number 346, wow. I forgot how far down on the Pokedex it was. Should be another Pokemon around here as well. One, and I want to catch one. Oh, wow, it's already level 10. Not using either of these. All right, it's flying, so, let's put you up here. All right, it's electric, so let's have it zap some things. Aw, too bad. Paralyze. Dang it. Ooh. Yeah, this thing is tough. It's got fairly high attack power. Would this be enough? Ah. Goodbye, not Pikachu. Thank you. All right, I'm gonna swap in to. Rock. Choose next. It should be able to survive a peck, at least. I want to revive, not Pikachu. There we go. Oh, good, it went for double kick. Ooh. All right, should go down with this. Yeah. Bye-bye.
Bye.
There we go. There it is. Paldean Wooper. There's one.
I so want to use one of these on this file so bad. But I've got other Pokemon in mind that I want to use. And besides, I've got one on my personal file that I'm raising, so yeah. It is Poison Ground, so not going to use Thundershock. Oh yeah, it's also got Mudshot this early. Now the next question is, does this one have Water Absorb? Alright, fire's new tool to ground. I could have used Ember. Hey, big pecs! Alright, let's catch it. One, two, three. I got a Whoopi Boy. After losing a territorial struggle, Wooper began living on the land. The Pokemon changed over time, developing a poisonous film to protect its body. Alright. Oh, since it's not fully evolved, there we go. It looks so happy. All right, let's restore your health. All right. If I'm in the menu, you can't get me. Oh, went all the way down there. All right, Flamigo, let's go. You wanted to take me up so bad? Well, here I am. Oh, it's only level 5. This should be easy. Oh, it's trying to paralyze me. How cute. It's a shame that Electro Pokemon can't be paralyzed now. I think that was a change as of Gen 6. Bye-bye. Hey, Wigglet learned rap. There's an Azurill. It's another Whoopi Boy. All right, I can take selfies. All right, so I'm gonna take a selfie with this Wooper, or you know, this Azurill. There we go. Where's the Wooper? Where is the Wooper? I had a Wooper around here. Oh, I lost it. Dang it. Oh, that was a super potion. Nice. There's one. Let me take this thing out. Level 7. Oh, it is actually flying. Aw, too bad. That was a critical? Holy crap. Oh, no. Oh, God. At least there's that.
All right, Lapork. Please be fully paralyzed and not, and if you aren't, don't use double kick. Oh, good. It couldn't move because it's paralyzed, the game says as it's still flying. All right, because it's a fighting type, it's weak to fairy. So I technically made the right choice. There we are. Oh? Oh, good, it's gonna evolve into Spewpa.
There we go.
Your Scatterbug evolved into Spewpa. If Rufflet attacks this Pokemon by pecking at it, it will retaliate with its sharp fur and poisonous black powder. Ooh. Never seen it with that. Oh, good. Protect. Alright, so there's definitely fast traveling. And I gotta get over there. Let's get back to the lighthouse. That way I don't have to run all the way over there. Perfect. So yeah, Flamigo gives out a lot of experience, which is gonna be very good early on. Let's check the summary of you. 1110, shed skin, nice. Let's see, move. So yeah, let's check the summary of the one we caught. Look at that attack power at level 6. Tangled Feet boosts the Pokemon's evasiveness if it's confused. I did not get that one on mine. I forgot what it's what the ability of it is on mine.
Hey, let's battle!
So yeah, I'm in front of it. He sees me, but he's not approaching. If you talk to a Pokemon trainer like me, it means we're gonna battle. So one of the changes they did is trainers no longer approach you as soon as they see you. You have to actually talk to them to initiate the battle. So yeah, if you don't want to battle any trainers, you're more than welcome to. You're more than welcome to avoid them entirely. Ow. Ha ha. And you only have one Pokemon. That's a weird sound. Here in Paldea, you gotta talk to a Pokemon trainer to challenge him. We can't tell if you want a battle just by making eye contact. About damn time they made that change. The hell was that sound? Sounded like a coin. Some berry. Oh, there it is. Okay, good. I got a Gimmickle coin.
So yeah, roaming form Gimmagool can be found, but they cannot be caught. You will be able to find a chest form Gimmagool later on. And sometime next year, you'll be able to connect with Pokemon Go to be able to get the roaming form. Ah, Ralts! Let's swap over to Lepork. Get you a little leveled up. There we go. The hell was that sound? Ralts knows Aroma Veil. Okay. A good voice. Oh, you made a mistake. Thought you would be able to avoid all my attacks? Think again. Oh wow, I've already been streaming for 2 hours. Alright, so once I get to the Pokemon Center, I will end things off. And then next time, we'll work on actually making it over to the school. The horn on its head provides a strong power that enables it to sense people's emotions. No. Another one! It's another Whoopi Boy! Alright, Lepork. There we go. I caught the Wild Whooper off guard. All right, tackle. Keep on tackling it. There we go. The Wild Whooper was caught off guard and couldn't move. So basically, we just made it not be able to attack on its first turn. There we go. Oh yeah, I want to check the ability of the Whooper I caught earlier. So what ability do you have? Oh good, it's got Water Absorb. Which means it has a Water Immunity instead of a Water Weakness. Oh my god, it's a bunch of Fido. Let's, oh, Igglybuff as well. All right, I'll catch one of each. Woof. Woof. How is your special defense then? Also, it lowered my attack, so it probably did a little bit more. There we are. Throw! A two, a three, a three. There we are. The puppy Pokemon. Oh, it's pure fairy. I thought it was normal fairy. This Pokemon is smooth and moist to the touch. Yeast in Fido's breath induces fermentation in the Pokemon's vicinity. Oh, I can get contact drunk off of it. Alright. And one Igglybuff, please. Oh, wow. Okay. Oh, good. It's gonna have a stronger one. Like, that did any good, though? One, two, three. Boom.
There we are. Its body has a faintly sweet scent and is bouncy and soft. If it bounces even once, it cannot stop. It is a balloon. Which means Wigglytuff is in the game. Alright, boxes. I'm gonna put Ralts in my box. So yeah, these are all the Pokemon we've caught, and as you can see, there's actually a pretty good variety. Right off the bat. It's impressive. Oh, there's a trainer here. I think I'll take on the trainer and then I'll head to the Pokemon Center and then end off. Let me get this item. Potion. If you can beat me, I'll tell you a cool secret. I nearly dropped my drink.
LeChonk. Le pork.
Aw, yours is only level 5. Let's tenderize that pork loin. There we go. Nice. Oh, I lost even though my Pokemon had full HP. Yeah, mine only had half. Here's the secret. Pokemon Stars will heal all your Pokemon for free because healthcare in the Pokemon universe is vastly better. What do you mean you already knew that? Oh, I think I saw an item up here. God, it's easy to get distracted. All right. There we go. Oi, Vickles, over here. This here's the Pokemon Center. You can come here and take care of a lot of things related to your Pokemon. But I'll leave the explanations up to the pros here. Happy to be of service. Welcome to the Pokemon Center. I am Joybot 001. Hello, and welcome to Pokemart. Insert coins to buy. And right here is the technical machine, a TM machine for short. It's your ticket to making TMs. You'll need to pay in life points and materials. Life points come in handy at these machines, and I've got, and at stores. I've got a lot, so here, have my life force. Oh, I had all ones for my LP. I ruined it. And I got some materials. And at the Union Circle, you can connect with other trainers if you have Switch Online for the account you're playing with. I don't have it for the specific account, so I'm not going to use it. Single player, baby! Come visit us at the Pokemon Center anytime you need my help. We will, thanks. Remember, had a rough adventure? Get to the Pokemon Center and don't get zapped by the malfunctioning Joybot. Alright. And this is where you learn that you can take your Pokemon out. Let's go on ahead and heal. Hello and welcome to Pokemon Center. Insert Pokemon for healing. We will need your Pokemon for a few seconds. Initializing healing subroutine .exe. LeChonk and your Pokemon should be all better now. Oh, by the way, did you know? When you're feeling lost. Oh, did you already know that? Error.
Come see us again, human meatbag. Welcome to Pokemon Mart. Insert coins to buy. Oh, wow. Only 300 for a Poke Doll. That is a very detailed picture. Or just a very sharp-looking picture. Let's buy 10 of these for no apparent reason. And yeah, you can pay with either, I think they're called League Points, actually. Or cash. But to make TMs, you have to pay with League Points. Along with the materials. And let's see what we can actually make. I want a TM made. Mud Slap. Protect. Low Kick. Struggle Bug. Disarming Voice. Swift. Palmy is physical oriented, so that may not be a good idea. Endure. And that's it. But, these are available to you super early on. And, ooh. Alright, so I'm going to tell you right now, Houndour materials, Shinx materials. I don't know which one this is. But if I can get enough, if I can find some Shinx and battle them, I can actually teach Palmy a better electric move for its stats. Alright, so that's actually good to know. Oh, I need another Psyduck down. But none of my Pokemon can learn it. Is there anything else I can help you with? Thank you, and come again. Unlike these two bots, I am an actual human. Alright, so yeah, this is where we're gonna end things off today. Next time I stream this, we're gonna make our way up that way to the campus. So until next time, YouTube, thank you for watching and take it easy. I'll see you later.